Hamilton. Mercedes may have weak spot this year. Lewis Hamilton has expressed concerns that the rule changes for this year may have left Mercedes with a weak spot within the new aerodynamic regulations. He believes this weak spot has the potential to end Mercedes' run of dominance, risking their chance of a sixth consecutive constructors' title. Team boss Toto Wolff has previously suggested that any of the teams on the grid have the potential to lead the championship if they find something to exploit in the new regulations that other teams do not spot. This year there is the possibility that a team managed to spot a loophole in the new rules and in turn they may gain a significant advantage. Hamilton has publicly supported Mercedes and said that they will come up with the answers, but he also warned that their dominant run may come to an end if they change their approach. He praised the team, saying, "If you look at the team's performance on the race weekend, that our mechanics, our engineers, strategists, we've all raised our game." He added that it was inspiring for him and that he did not want to let them down. The new regulations for the 2019 season include a simplified front wing, a deeper and wider rear wing, and removal of winglets from brake ducts. Formula One made the changes with the aim of making it easier for cars to follow another driver more closely without losing downforce, which they hope will lead to more overtaking. The sports bosses have acknowledged that it may take until 2020 for the benefits of the changes to be seen across the grid, so it remains to be seen if any of the teams have found a loophole that they have been able to exploit and if Mercedes will be taking another Constructors' Championship. Hamilton showed his confidence and expressed support for his team, "For next year's car, I have an idea where the weak spot will be with these rule changes. As long as Mercedes don't change their approach, don't change their desire to win. As long as they don't do that, I believe that we'll be able to stay on this path and continue to fight at the top." Next news: Wolff doubtful on impact of new rules. The majority of Formula One fans know the new rules to be implemented in 2019. Aimed at reducing turbulence for the car behind and therefore making overtaking easier, producing a better spectacle for the supporter. The move, which has forced teams to make their front wings more simple and their rear wings wider and deeper, was well supported at the time it was announced, but now Toto Wolff, team boss of Mercedes, has doubted that the change will affect racing as much. Wolff believes that teams have found a way to redirect airflow around the car once again, negating the changes made to the wings. He said, "At the moment it is very difficult for the cars to follow because you lose downforce, the tire loses grip and therefore the overtaking is really bad. When you look at some of the junior classes, like F2 for example, there's some great racing there actually. They are able to come close." The aim was to take away some of the aero and direct the airflow over the top of the car, but they fight 2,000 aerodynamicists in all the teams and I think we have found solutions to get the air around the car, so it's not going to change an awful lot. Next news: Wehrle in set for Ferrari development driver role. Former Mercedes junior driver Pascal Wehrlein is set to take up a development driver role at Scuderia Ferrari. The German was under contract with Mercedes until December 31 but has reportedly paid a visit to the Italian team's base in Maranello ahead of an official announcement. Mercedes officially cut ties with Wehrlein after being unable to find him a seat in Formula One last year. Instead, the 24-year-old is set to compete in Formula E this season with the Mahindra team. With change already well underway at Ferrari with Mattia Binotto replacing Maurizio Arrivabene as team principal, Wehrlein's arrival is another move by the team planning for the future. The former Sauber driver will replace Dani Ogvet in the simulator and developmental role after the Russian left the team to rejoin Toro Rosso for the 2019 season. Although no official confirmation has been made yet, Motorsport Italy reports that Wayrlaton's appearance at Maranello after the conclusion of his Mercedes contract is directly linked to the filling of the role team leader Sebastian Vettel was keen to fill. Next news: Todd believes that there is too much hidden simulation in F1. FIA President Jean Todt believes F1 is becoming too reliant on hidden simulation, which he believes is bad for the sport. Restrictions on the amount of in-season testing have resulted in teams increasingly using simulator drivers at their factory bases to help improve car setups. Todt believes that this is impacting Formula One in a negative way due to the fact that the fans are unable to witness what goes on behind closed doors. Things are changing, sometimes for the good, sometimes less good, Todt said in an interview with Sky Sports F1. I feel that cars are too reliable. I feel, there's, too much happening that you don't see. Simulation. Drivers simulating race circuit in the factory during the race weekend or any other period without any limitation. In a way, I miss sometimes the past. I miss private testing, everybody was complaining it's too much private testing. At least you could see what was happening. Todt believes F1 would benefit from restrictions on how teams are able to use the data they collect. Probably it was too much, but now I think it's too much hidden simulation in the factory, he added. Clearly sometimes modernity is good, but it should be also a bit more controlled. Sebastian Vettel admitted that he did not like testing in the simulator, so maybe this could be beneficial for both the drivers and the fans. Thank you for watch video. Subscribe now to know the latest sports information.